Dana Damley here with MStayers Realty Partners, bringing you another episode of At Home with Dana. And today I'm standing outside the Shops of Bandera here in my hometown, Bandera, Texas. So we are going to do a small business highlight, and we're going to interview Sarah, who was the creator of this whole concept inside. So let's get in there and see what Sarah's doing. So we're here with Sarah, the owner of the Shops of Bandera and Hill Country Carts. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for being here.
Actually, I came here, so thank you for having us.
Thanks for being here.
Awesome. Well, Sarah, once a quarter I try to do a small business highlight, and I know it was about 1 year ago, you had saw a video of me painting or something, and you asked me to come to a class, and you told me this crazy idea you had for a Main Street real estate right here in Bandera, Texas. Can you tell us that crazy idea?
Yeah, just over a year ago, I had an idea, and I really thought it would do well, and what's funny is the business that's developed in this space was almost an afterthought. I wanted to do cart rentals, like when you go to the beach and you get a golf cart. And so I decided to do cart rental business here. And the building has a garage, so it was a natural,
awesome,
you know, decision. But I had to take everything or nothing. And they told me
everything being this
the building.
Okay.
Yeah, so I needed the courtyard and the garage, and that was it. But I couldn't break it apart. So I know the family, and they were excited about that idea, and they encouraged me to do an antique mall or something in that nature.
Okay.
And I wasn't really wanting to go all in any one direction, but I'll be honest, I had parents that were crafters and creators, and I grew up going to craft shows, and that's like carny life for crafters. It's really hard, and they did metalwork, and so they started with trinkets and, you know, things that they packed up and hauled to a different city every weekend and set it up and tore it down, and, you know, that allowed them to grow in their business to bigger things, you know, and now they do gate work, and they don't would say no to anything that was what
transient.
Yes. Yeah. Anything that put food on the table during those days is like, whew, we don't have time for that now.
Right.
So I just figured, I know that Bandera's in our area, we have so many creative people and so many passionate people about what they do, and some of it's offbeat, and I love that.
Yeah.
And I wanted to be able to have a place where people felt like they were represented in their art, in their craft, in their creation or collection.
Right.
And so I decided to do the same model as the other vendor markets, and I really tried to focus on local handmade. Mm-hmm. So that allowed me to do the carts in the back, and I do the shops in the front, and you came for a class because I do hold crafting classes when we're out, able to meet up and gather and all of that, you know, we'll really get that going. And I also have transitioned to take the warehouse in the courtyard to be an outdoor venue.
Okay, awesome.
That's in the works right now.
That's in the
works. Yeah, it's a lot.
You had a, before COVID, you were really starting to get a calendar together.
Yeah.
Of the, like, do-it-yourself crafts.
Yeah.
I did paint pouring, but you had, tell me about some of the classes you had.
I've encouraged my vendors to teach a class if their craft, what they have here, is something that can be taught. Mm-hmm. And a lot of them are creative in other ways that they don't even do here.
Right.
And so Sherry that does Sugi Bees, she does beeswax and goat's milk lotions and all of that sort of stuff. And she's held a class doing bath bombs and lip balms, but she also does mosaic tiles. And so she's done broken china pots, and she's done stained glass mosaics and a couple different things. We had a lot that we were about to jump in and start doing whenever we decided it was probably not good to have gatherings. So we've stalled out on that, but that's okay. Good time.
The store seems to still be doing really well.
We're actually doing really well. You know, we've got great people. Everyone here has something different from one another, and that's because I make sure that I don't bring in something that conflicts. And I think I got a phone call earlier from somebody that wants to do candles, but I'm looking at candles right here.
Right.
So I'm true to making sure that if someone comes in and says, hi, I'm looking for candles, I say, here you go. You know, I don't have a choice of this one or that one.
Right.
There's no competition. We're all cheering for each other, with each other, because we have our own little niche. And that's hard because with antiques and stuff, but everything is still very different. And that allows me to hopefully have things different from other places, and I can still send business down to everyone else. And we are across from the hotel that finally just opened, so we know we're going to have a lot of foot traffic that we've been lacking before. And one of the things that was important to me was to feel like we were successful before that, so that I wasn't just sitting here waiting on it. So now it's really just going to be bonus, you know, that they are open.
Well, that's exciting, because that kind of
helps me transition to the carts. I want to spend some time on that. Yeah. So yeah. Tell me your vision about that.
So typically when you see cart rentals like down at the beach, they're golf carts. Right. And that's what everyone, and a lot of people have their own personal golf cart here. Mm-hmm. So we're a community that's already got this, you know, out on our streets. I did my due diligence to figure out what I needed to do to have it legitimate and everything. And so I didn't know that golf carts were a good answer because we're a town with a lot of horse trailers and big dualies, and you know, I want safety to be a priority.
They can't see them.
Yeah.
Run someone over.
And golf
good.
Carts are light, and so I chose to do street legal UTVs instead.
Okay.
So like an ATV, but okay. it's utility. So
gotcha.
it's gonna be like your gator or your mule on the ranch,
yeah.
which in this town that's what a lot of people are used to anyway.
Right.
So it made sense to me. And so they're completely street legal. They've got brake lights. They run on gas. They've got some engine power.
Have you done a Hunter's Weekend yet?
I did. Yeah. The very first Hunter's Weekend here in this business was about 2 weeks after I opened.
Oh, okay.
So I wanted to get my feet wet and see how things went before a big weekend. And they were booming. You know, I mean, that was the hot ticket that weekend. So. They're parked right here on the road so that when you drive by, you see them, you know, and it grabs attention. And they're little red buggies. They're candy
That's
apple
cute.
Red. So
I love it. I love it.
Yeah.
Well, Sarah, thank you so much.
I also can trailer them to other locations.
Oh, okay.
So I can do like a party where you shuttle guests or a lot of events around here run with a lot of staff. And so, you know, I take them to Mansfield Park and
cool.
or even local RV parks where they're just used to get around campsites.
Wow.
So, lots of options.
Do you plan on growing your
I do. I started with my fleet of three.
Uh-huh.
And
I love it.
I did assume that I would be growing by this point, but it's okay. It's okay.
Yeah.
Everything happens for a reason, and we're still here. We're strong. We rerouted a few things. In fact, the RV, you know, option for me to take carts to an RV park happened because of COVID.
Right.
People were traveling more, you know, in the ways that they could, and I started getting business for that, and I didn't even anticipate that.
Right.
So it became a new avenue for me to look into.
Okay.
So I usually tell people that showing off Bandera, that's my slogan, that's my goal.
Okay.
You know, my carts can get you around to see our town, and my shops can bring you in to see what people hear. What they do.
Yeah.
This, you know, you're going to see your neighbor, your coworker, you know,
That's
somebody
awesome.
You might not have even known does that as a hobby or, you know,
right.
this is a way to really truly show off Bandera. And I love that because I'm from
too.
Here and I'm a part of this community. So it feels good.
That's awesome. I'm glad you moved back to Bandera.
Yeah.
I'm not far away.
No.
I haven't exactly moved back, but
you are close.
Yeah. I am close,
yeah.
but thank you so much for letting us
come
to your shops and do classes. And anyway, it's pretty special, and I hope that you just keep.
We're going to keep going.
Keep going
keep
and
growing,
keep going.
Keep growing. Yeah.
All right, guys, that's it for At Home with Dana. We'll see you next week.
Thank you.